inference for one proportion. If n times p is large enough, we can use the normal approximation to compute a confidence interval or a p-value for a hypothesis test. Otherwise, we can use the binomial distribution. We'll look at C1, the nominal binary variable, to talk about the true proportion of people who would say yes. We can go to Stat, Basic Statistics, One Proportion. Samples and columns is the one column of data that we want to look at, nominal binary. If your data is already summarized, you could enter it using this option. If you want to perform a hypothesis test, you need to check this box. First, we'll just compute a confidence interval. We do need to go to Options to set the confidence level. Keep the alternative hypothesis at not equal if you'd like a two-sided confidence interval. And if that size is large enough, you can check off the box to use the normal distribution. We can see the last item in the output is the confidence interval. And also included in the output is that this is based on the normal approximation to the binomial distribution. Next, we'll look at a hypothesis test. Suppose we want to see if a majority of people would say yes in the population. We'll go back to the Stat Basic Statistics menu and choose one proportion. We are still using the nominal binary data. This time we will perform the hypothesis test. If we're looking for a majority, the null value is going to be 50% or 0.5. Next, we need to change the alternative hypothesis by pressing the Options button. Greater than would denote a majority. If n times 0.5 is large enough, we can leave this box checked for the normal distribution. The p-value appears as the last value in our output. Let's suppose we want to take another sample to detect a proportion as large as 0.75 with power of 0.90. Minitab can compute that sample size for us if we go to the Stat menu, Power and Sample Size, One Proportion. We'll leave the sample size area blank because that's what we want to compute. Alternative values of p, we want to detect a proportion of 0.75. Power is given as 0.90. Hypothesized p is the null value from our hypotheses. That's 0.5. Under Options, we need to change the alternative hypothesis to greater than if we're looking for a majority. And we can change the significance level if desired. By default, Minitab will draw the power curve. If we go back to the session window, we can see the output shows a sample size for us of 31.